What's up, world? This is Swedish Gringo, and as you can see, I've actually got a normal job. When I'm not out traveling the world, I work as a reporter slash web editor slash videographer something something. These desks are normally packed with hardworking, decent people doing important stuff for all the citizens out there. But because of the coronavirus screwing up all my plans, I'm nowadays sitting here all by myself. Anyways, I thought we could do this a new way now. Since no one of us can really travel, let's go meet some of the most interesting people I've ever met in one of the most spectacular places in the world. We're talking about the Bedouins in the ancient city of Petra in Jordan. Let's have a look. The ruins of Petra in Jordan have recently emerged as one of the prime tourist destinations in the world. Every year, almost 1 million people visit this mythical place, which 13 years ago was named one of the world's 7 new wonders. But Petra is not just an echo of a lost civilization. For hundreds of years, the historical site has also been home to the so-called Budul tribe, a group of Bedouins who consider themselves relatives of the original inhabitants. Life as a Bedouin in Petra is hard. The tourist destination generates millions of dollars annually, but for many of the people who live here permanently, hunger is part of everyday life. Historically, the Bedouins in Petra have made a living from farming and goat herding. Nowadays, the absolute majority rely on tourism, with the exclusive right to sell souvenirs and food and offer camel and donkey tours to tourists. But competition is razor sharp, and for some, a whole day under the blazing sun only results in small change. In a barren valley far away from the tourist hiking trails, live some of the Budul Bedouins who refuse to move despite heavy pressure from the Jordan government. And we're not talking about no boring concrete houses here. The followers of the Budul tribe are known to, like their predecessors in Petra, live in caves carved right into the ancient mountain. The cave, roughly 20 square meters, houses 17-year-old Samra, her 1-year-old son, her mother Ghazami, 4 sisters and a brother. Crowded but free, the authorities try hard to convince these last remaining Bedouins to leave Petra, but have no right to either force them out or demand any rent for the caves. Still, Samra and her family often discuss whether life would be easier if they moved to the newly built Bedouin village a few kilometers away. Over there, you always have work and electricity. There is a hospital, and you have the opportunity to go to school every day. Hey, thanks for watching! If you want to know more about the life of the Bedouins in Petra, check out my full article. The address is right over here. You get the pictures, you get the text, the full story. It's a good one. So, next up is a crazy jungle adventure in the deep forests of Madagascar. Tune in a couple of weeks to enjoy it. By the way, That was also the last trip I managed before Corona made us all prisoners in our own homes. Let's hope this madness ends soon, cause this gringo needs to travel. Take care, everyone. Stay safe.